Hello, YouTube, and welcome back to Slashoween.
It's showtime.
Episode, after cleansing my mind from the horror that was Where the Dead Go to Die, I figured we would take a look not at a movie or even a franchise, but a character. A character who I'm sort of dressed up as right now. Today, we're talking about Freddy Krueger.
Okay, that's kind of a neat idea, looking at a horror icon and just seeing what makes them so scary.
Indeed, my dear Clyde, indeed. Oh, and I'm glad that you're finally sane after seeing the last film.
Yeah, I think I took antidepressants or something to make me forget about the film.
Well, those do definitely help. I didn't take any, though. I just went straight to alcohol. Just kidding. I just kept bashing my head in with a baseball bat till I forgot most of the movie. I wish I were joking. And so, we're going to be looking at one of the most prolific horror icons out there, Freddy Krueger, or as most of you know him, Freddy. Portrayed by Robert Englund and once by Jackie Earle Haley in the Nightmare on Elm Street series, Freddy Krueger is one of the most, well-known of horror icons. What is about him that makes him so scary, though? Some of you might be wondering that. And that is what we are discussing. What exactly is it that makes Freddy Krueger so terrifying? Is it the way he looks, the way he sounds, his weapon, what he does? What is it? I think it's a mixture of all that.
Hey, don't I get to talk about any of this?
Alright, you get a section to talk, Clyde, okay? But let me do the first one first because I'm the host, okay?
Okay.
Here we go. So, the first one we're going to talk about is, Freddy's voice, honestly, because that's probably one reason why he's so scary. Freddy doesn't exactly have a deep, booming voice that you'd expect from someone who can go into your dreams. All he is a scrawny old man covered in burns, wearing a sweater, a fedora, with knives on his, fingers, on a glove. That is scary on its own. But his voice isn't even that scary, but the way he says things, that is what's so scary about him. Like, you heard my impression of earlier, everyone knows Freddy's voice. It's like this.
I'm your boyfriend now, Nancy.
Or?
Ever played Skin the Cat?
Yeah, Freddy's got an intimidating voice, usually depending on certain films. Sometimes it's his voice a little more high-pitched, but it's Freddy's commanding, creepy voice that's one reason why he's so scary. And another reason, Clyde?
Ask anyone growing up in the 2000s, the 90s, the 80s, pretty much any horror fan, and they know what Freddy looks like. With his brown fedora hat, his twisted burnt face, his red and green striped sweater, and of course, his finger knives. Whether they be attached to his hand or his glove, you know what Freddy Krueger looks like. And in almost every film, his appearance is enough to make anyone scared. Especially when he twists his, you know, appearance at times. Make himself turn into a puppet, or even a woman. You know, since Freddy's in his nightmares, he can change his appearance. And yet, for the most part, he stays in one single appearance. That creepy sweater, fedora, and glove with his twisted, burnt face.
Appearance is definitely a major factor in what makes him so scary. Another one is his powers and who he goes after. Freddy is known for going after mostly children. That is one reason why he's so creepy. He rarely goes after adults. He goes after children and teenagers. That is who he targets. And that's what's so scary. Never go into an old woman's yard if she has a rake with razors on it. I'm just kidding. At least I pray to God I am. It's much scarier when you see Freddy going after kids and teenagers, since they can't properly defend themselves. Even in their dreams, they need help from adults. Like, seriously, it's usually the adults that... Well, to be honest, the adults in these movies do suck. They never believe the kids even when they have frickin' proof. Said, it wouldn't be as scary if Freddy just went after adults. He goes after kids and teenagers. Like, it's actually still scary when he goes after, Heather, you know, the main character for the first film and the third film, when he goes after her again in the third film, because we've already seen how she goes through this. We know she can't even defend herself even when she's older. But still, since we were with her the first time, we're still scared for her. And that brings me to our fourth one. Clyde?
Part of the fear of Freddy Krueger comes from, in the films, we're right beside his victims. We're right beside Nancy, Jamie, the kids from the third film. We are right beside them as they are twisted down by Freddy. And so we feel their fear whenever he goes after them. Not only in their dreams, but also when they pull him out, he's still a threat. Even if he does get his butt kicked at times, like in the first film when he gets caught in all those traps that Nancy set. That is what's so scary about him. We are right there beside his victims when he goes after them, and thus, we feel the fear that they do.
So whether it's his voice, his outfit, who he goes after, or the people themselves who try to defend themselves against Freddy, that is why he's so scary. It's a combination of all those different things that makes him so scary.
But as the films go on, the fear is massively diluted.
Yeah, it doesn't last as much when you get to the sequels. He's really scary at first, but then as they go on, he just sort of becomes a Wile E. Coyote character almost.
If need we mention the reboot?
Heck no, the makeup looked so awful, mixed with CGI, and he looked like he was a zombie with cheese on his face. I didn't get scared at all with the new one. Like, there was only one or two moments where I actually got scared, but when the reboot came out, this was my reaction, really. That's me when a jump scare happens. I just get startled for a second, and then that's it. Freddy is not scary in the reboot. Even if Jackie O'Haley did do a dang good job, he's just not scary as scary as the original.
Yeah, and with the original Freddy, all the stuff he did, going through the wall, attacking people, that was practical effects. Very rarely was something not there. But with the new one, it's pretty much just all poor CGI.
Most of the effects in the reboot, you could tell it was fake. Just a quick character study, and then we're moving on to our next film. And trust me, this next one I am giddy for. It is so, so stupid. But in an enjoyable way. I'll see you next time.